Forza Horizon 5 has loads of amazing custom EventLabs maps made by talented creators in the community. So I've picked out these 5 EventLabs maps you must try. Let's get straight into it. So let's start off with this map called K86 Gipfelstürmer. I hope I pronounced that right. But anyway, this is a brilliant toge map, which requires high precision to execute well. It's a great map from a challenge point of view, but also a really aesthetically pleasing map to look at. Next, we move on to Arc Drift City Dash GP, made by Arc Raiders. This is a really fun map to drift or race around, and it's full of really cool structures. At night in particular, it looks really good, all lit up. Unfortunately, there isn't a free roam version of this map as a result of an update. Arc Raiders himself said this on Discord, so yeah, devs, if you're watching, please fix this. But even without a free roam, it's still a nice map. Next up, we have Hong Kong Island, made by China 4567690. Based off the gamertag of the creator, we know there must be at least 4,567,689 other people who got there first with the name China. But jokes aside, this is a really cool map, which has petrol stations, car parks, showrooms, helipads, and a lot more. This map is very cleverly built because it utilizes the already existing structures of the city of Guanajuato. But with the use of props, it completely transforms it and makes it look so cool, which means there's so many brilliant places for taking photos in this map. And also, the size of this city sets it apart from a lot of other city maps because it's so big. For the penultimate map in this video, we have Canyon House by Fialhog21. I hope I pronounced your name correctly. This may seem like a more simple map, and perhaps it is, but it's still extremely cool and shows us how the player houses in FH5 should have been. Can you imagine if we could own player houses like this, and then assign different cars to the different parking bays? A bit like how you can in F1 22, that would be insane. As for this house in particular, it has a balcony with a lovely view of the canyon, and then it also has this garage below. In this map, you can take some stunning photos, and it is a prime example of the good things coming in small sizes. Lastly, we have this map called Somewhere Else in Japan, and it's made by NordseeBazi, who is possibly the best custom EventLab map designer in FH5. This is the insane modern city which FH5 lacks. With all the lit up buildings, it feels so alive, and it really makes you feel like you're driving in Japan. It has a little park and even a temple on the outskirts of this city, adding to the feel of authenticity. This map is good for everyone, regardless of what you enjoy doing, because it's perfect for cruising, drifting, photography, and pretty much everything else. But anyways, that's all the maps for this video. If you enjoyed this one, there's 4 previous episodes on this series, so be sure to check them out. And of course, smash the like button and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.